Diane Reevely and Ranger introduced 6 new colors of ink sprays and a number of new stencil designs at Winter 2014 CHA. The colors include Brights, Polished Jade, and Tangerine Dreams, Earth Tones, Chopped Pesto, Ground Coffee, and Pomegranate Seed, and that neutral gray. Today we'll look at various ways to use the new colors, including with the new stencils. My preference when working with dilutions is to dilute them with water, primarily because I like the colors better a little bit lighter, but from an economical standpoint, it also makes the colors last a little bit longer. So I've already worked with the other 4. I've diluted them out in bottles, and now what I have are Pomegranate Seed and Tangerine Dream, and I'll show you how I do that. And typically, I'm going to work with the empty Ranger bottles, and I'm going to fill them about 2/3 of the way full. I generally do 2 parts water to 1 part of the color. So this is Tangerine Dream. Let me come in, and I'm just going to put some of that in here till I'm at about that 2-to-1 ratio. Same thing with the Pomegranate Seed. I've already got water in my bottle. So I'm just going to come in and fill that up. Now, these are broken out, as I mentioned in the opening. We've got 3 earth tones. We have Pomegranate Seed. Sorry, let me get my notes. We have Pomegranate Seed. We have Ground Coffee and Chopped Pesto in the Earth Tone group, and then the 2 Brights are Polished Jade and Tangerine Dream, and then we have the neutral color gray. So let me show you how these work now, and this is just one of the Strathmore Art Journals with the watercolor paper. I'm going to put my scratch paper in here to kind of control the overspray. So I'm going to work with these 2, and I'm going to bring in Funky Fuchsia. This is obviously one of the previous colors. So I'm going to start with Tangerine Dream. Ooh, pretty, pretty bright orange color. Now this is even diluted. It's still this color. And let me get my bottle going here. This is Pomegranate Seed. And then I'm going to bring in a previous color, which is Funky Fuchsia, which I like a lot. And you know what? Just to try it, I think I'm going to bring in some of the Pomegranate Seed that has not been diluted. I'm just going to throw some of that deeper color in. And I'm going to come back with a little bit of the Funky Fuchsia up here, because this is really one of my favorite colors. Now I'm going to roll this with paper towel, which is something that you see Diane do. I'm not going to pick up all of the color. And if I am quick with my heat tool, I can actually catch some of the marks that the paper towels leave. Unfortunately, I wasn't quick enough, but that's okay. So let me dry this up, and then I'm going to bring in the new large size bubble stencil. I'm dry now, so I'm going to come in with the bubble stencil, and I think the first thing I'm going to do is a little bit of ghosting with it. So I'm going to bring a spray bottle with water in, and I'm going to mist it, and then I'm just going to come over here and print the remainder of the water on this side, and you can see immediately the reaction that's going on. These are really, I'm just going to dab this off. These are really, really nice colors. I'm really liking this Pomegranate Seed, and I'm especially liking the Tangerine Dream. So now that I've given that a few seconds to do its thing, let me just grab some relatively clean and dry paper towel, and I'm going to come in and I will pick up the color from the ghosting. Great, nice pattern here on this bubbles. Just nice circles. So many great things that you can do with this. Now I'm going to bring that stencil back in, and I'm actually going to use one of the Perfect Pearls mists. I have copper here, and I'm going to spray some of that through so I get some of the patterning going on. I'm going to spray that over here, and then I think I'll print some of the remainder over here. So I'm going to get really nice pattern, really nice texture, and I can tell already that I'm really liking these colors. I'll dry this up, and then we're going to move on, and we're going to do some other things with the other colors. I have to say I'm really loving these new colors. I did this spread with Polished Jade, Chopped Pesto, and some of the Slate Gray, and I'm really liking this combination. I thought it would be fun. This is the new Large Blocks stencil. This is the 9x12 version. I thought it would be fun to bring in some white linen. So that's what we're going to use with this stencil, and we'll see what happens. Now, of course, it's going to pick up these colors because they're not permanent. So I'm going to spray the white linen on here. Let's print it over here. And you can see the color picking up from underneath and changing the color of the white linen. Now, the quicker I dry this, the less color change there's going to be, but this is just fabulous. I'm really loving this a lot. Liking these colors, really having fun playing with them with the white linen. Now, this is going to fade a little bit too as it dries, so it's going to become a little bit more subtle, but it's still a really, really nice look. So this is one way to use white linen with these new colors. And the next way is to actually take it and mix it directly in a bottle. So let me just get this dried up, because I need to actually flip over to another page in my journal. This is almost done. It's just going to take a moment longer. With that other spread dry, I can flip over to another one in my journal, and now we can talk about mixing colors directly into the white linen to create a pastel pigmented version of whatever that color happens to be. Now, you can do this a couple of different ways. This is a bottle that was white linen that was nearly empty. I had maybe a quarter to a third of an inch left, sort of up from the bottom here, and I added Tangerine Dream directly into it. Now, the advantage is that A, you don't have to buy another bottle, and B, you can hear there's that little BB or pellet in there, whatever it is that helps distribute all the pigment. So when you reuse these bottles, you get to take advantage of that. If you use an empty bottle like I'm going to do here, you have to work just a tiny bit harder to go ahead and get that pigment distributed, but it's certainly doable. I have bottles like this that I've been using for a long time with many of the original colors. So really easy to do, not a problem at all. What I'm going to do, let me just move this forward. I'm going to shake this to make certain I've got the pigment distributed. I'm not going to put too much in here. I don't use these a ton, but when I do use them, I really like them because I get that kind of semi-opaque look, and I get really pretty pastel versions of the colors. So I'm going to come in with some polished jade. Now, I do need to mark this bottle so that I can come back to it in a few weeks and know what the heck it was. Let's see what this looks like. That looks like a pretty good color. I might add just a touch more to it to deepen it up a little bit. I'd rather do this in stages and find that I have to add a little bit more color than to find myself with something that's really dark that now I'm trying to add a bunch of white linen to go ahead and lighten it out to make it usable. So let's move this back in. This is one of the new stencil designs. It's called Triangles, and this is the larger 9x12 version of it. So I think I'm going to kind of do this along here, on this side anyway. Oh, how pretty is that? We get this color pumping through there. Really, really nice design. And I think I'm going to mimic that sort of coming back up this way. There we go. Get the bottle spraying properly. Really, really cool. So when you work with white linen and these colors, you can, when you think about it, excuse me, you have your version straight out of the bottle. If I can put my hand on it. Now I have another version that is watered down and lightened up. And then I have yet a third version that has been mixed with white linen. So one color will give you three different ways that you can use it, which is really nice. It allows you lots of diversity and lots of different things that you can do. The background on this page spread was created using Color Wash Butterscotch and then two of the new dilutions. I have Pomegranate Seed and Tangerine Dreams, and I deliberately kept the background fairly light because I want to do some other things to it. So what I'm going to do is bring in, this is my mix of white linen and pomegranate seed, and this is the new shattered stencil. So I'm going to just spray this through here a little bit to get some additional patterning on here because I want to show you some other things that you can do with the dilutions in addition to just working with sprays. I mean, sprays are wonderful, and it's something that we all do very frequently, myself included, but it's not the end-all be-all. So I do want to show you that in just one second. I'm going to dry this off. And with this dry now, what I want to do, this is the Dilutions ink spray pad, and it is empty. It is waiting for you to add your own color. These have been around for a little while now. If you haven't used one, they're really easy and they are oh so much fun. So let me move this journal out of the way. Now when you're going to add color to these, you have to give it a light mist of plain water just to kind of prime it and then rub your finger on it. That helps moisten the surface. Let me just grab some paper towel and wipe this up. Once you've got that set, I'm going to use three colors and I'm going to use my watered down version. I have butterscotch, pomegranate seed, and someplace here I have tangerine dream, if I can actually put my hand on it. Here it is. So I've got these three colors. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start, I don't know why I'm shaking, I don't need to shake. I'm going to start with pomegranate seed in the two corners, and then I'm going to put tangerine dream in the center and on one side, and then I will fill in with butterscotch in the other two openings. Now, these ink spray pads are really great. They can be washed out, you can reuse them, although my preference is not to do that. I leave the colors as they are, and I can tell you that because the pads don't seal tightly, this will dry out in some period of time. But don't panic, don't think that it's bad or anything like that. All you have to do is come in, like I did to start it initially to prime that surface, come in with your plain water, your spray bottle, and then just go ahead and re-ink, or if you will, revive what's already in the pad, and you can do that. Here's one that I had from ages ago. This is totally dry. I mean, if I rub my fingers on it, I'm not going to get any color off, but if I were to come back and miss this, then these colors would come right back to life, and I could use it in the same way that I'm about to show you with this other one. So I'm going to bring this journal back in, and I'm going to take one of the Dilutions background stamps. This is from the, let's just see here. This is from the Background Love set. It would help if I flipped it over so you could see it. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to ink it across multiple colors so that when I print with this, or I stamp with this, if you will, I'm actually going to stamp in multiple colors. And it's really cool. I'm going from yellow to orange to pink here. So really, really fun things that you can do. I can add lots of background color and texture that didn't show up particularly well there, but really great things that you can do. I mean, obviously if I had picked a lighter area, you would have seen it more. Let's come in here and do some there. This is very subtle because of the colors that I'm using and because there's already some color on this background, but you can see what happens. So you get this really cool stuff going on. Now something else that you can do. Take the bottom of any one of your bottles and just press it on there. And again, you can pick up and you get these rings that are multiple colors. Wipe it off and I can come back and move it in another area, and now I'm going to pick up tangerine and butterscotch, and those are going to be the colors on there. So these ink spray pads are really great. You can make them in any color combination that you choose, which is really nice, and as I said, you can use one pad repeatedly over and over. You just take this to the sink and rinse it under running water, but to my mind that's kind of wasteful because you end up tossing all that color you sprayed on here down the sink. So I like to have several of them that I keep favored color combinations in, and then I can just come back and use them whenever I want, just spraying them lightly with water to revive the color. I want to revisit the ink spray pad just for a moment before we move on to the last technique. That last spread was probably dark enough that you couldn't really see the way the color travels because you can use this stamp to span multiple colors when you ink it up. And so I have colors that go from the Tangerine Dream, this is the Color Wash Butterscotch, right across to the Pomegranate Seed. And you can lean this into one color more than another so that you're a little bit more heavily into one color more than another. But it's really nice because you get this blending as you move across, and I'm not going to put this away. I made the mistake of putting the last ones away, and out of sight really is out of mind, and I had forgotten how much I enjoy using these. So these are going to stay out for a while. So moving on to the very last technique, I want to talk about filling the detail water brushes with the Dilutions. And you can see that I'm very lucky. I have a whole, this is just a plastic glass that I picked up, full of these that I've done a little bit at a time, and they're all labeled so I know what's inside. And this is all of the colors of Dilutions, and in the Color Wash line, the ones that I use with frequency, because I color with these all the time when I have stamped images. So this is actually really simple to do. They are sold like this, and this is actually a two-piece unit. So you have the brush head up here. There's this little sponge section in here that gets wet from the color or the water that's in the reservoir here, and that's how you can go ahead and you can paint with these. You can see this has already got color coming through the tip. So in order to protect the water or the liquid in the reservoir from just streaming out, there's this little black insert. So what you have to do is remove that, and then I'm going to bring in pomegranate seed because that's what I want to use next. Now, you can use a pipette to do this if you want. I actually don't have any difficulty pouring this in. This might be mixed a little bit dark, so I think what I'm going to do is just pour some in. And then I'm going to leave some room, and I'm going to put just some plain water in. I think I want to lighten this up just a little bit. Okay, there we go. might have overfilled that just a smidge, but hopefully not. We'll see. So you put that black piece back in. Again, that protects the liquid from draining out of the reservoir. And then you take and screw your top back on. And you can see this little nib. You can see it right in there, that little black nib. That pokes down through here and is what allows the liquid to flow from the reservoir to the brush tip. So what you do is take the cap off, and you can see that there's nothing in here right now, and there's actually nothing in here. But if I give this a squeeze, the color starts to feed down, and it will eventually feed into those bristles. And there it goes. So what do you do with this? Well, it's really easy to color and to paint things once you have it set up. So this is one that I did a few moments ago. This is polished jade. This, I think, is either purple twilight or something else from the Color Wash line. I'm sorry, I can't think of it. And this is the chopped pesto in here. So I've got a flamingo. Seems like a perfect excuse to use, yeah, this is actually pretty dark, to go ahead and use pomegranate seed and to use tangerine dreams. So I'm not doing a very good job, but you can see how easy it is to color in here because you have this nice fine tip. Oh gosh, I'm doing a dreadful job here. But anyway, you have this nice fine tip that you can apply the color with. Now, if I wanted to, again, I can just feed this down into here, get that going. There it goes. I can stroke color right along the existing color, and I can get some blending going on here too. So depending on the size of what you're working on, you have the option to do a little bit more painterly things than just straight coloring like I'm sort of doing in this wing. There's lots of different ways that you can use these, and as I said, I'm really lucky. I've been able to grab brushes here and there, and I've got them filled up so that when I'm ready to go, I have all the colors that I want to work with. And this is very often, whoops, I guess it would help if I did his beak. This is very often how I color my images, then I cut them out and I apply them to my journal pages. So you can see that you have a real luxury of working in lots of different ways here once you have your colors, whether you're using them diluted or you're using them straight from the bottle, you mix them with white linen, or you put them in the water brushes, and you know, you've got this great opportunity to use these colors in many, many different ways. When I finished filming that last segment, I really believed I was finished with this video, but as it happens, I was not. A little bit later that day, I was looking through a stack of books and I came across this one. Written by Diane Reevely and published by Ranger, this is called My Creative Journal Journey, and it's about a year old now, and this is Diane's process very much from start to end that explains all of the steps that she takes when she creates her journal pages. Now, I thought that it would be fun to come back and to talk about this primarily from the viewpoint of all of the products that are new since this book was published, because obviously these techniques are useful universally. It doesn't matter what colors you use or anything like that, so your own color preferences and your processes and your techniques really will meld quite nicely when you pick up on some of the things that she's showing you here. So what I would like to do is I'm going to create a spread up through to the point where if I were going to write on the page or if I were going to collage some images, that would be where I would end, because I don't want to, you know, fill this video with stuff that we don't necessarily need to see relative to these new colors. So I'm going to work with pomegranate seed, polished jade, and slate gray. Then I'm going to show you some of the steps that she takes in the book. Now, before I go too far, a couple of things that I want to mention. This video will be released on Wednesday, February 26, 2014. Any order placed from that day through the end of the day on Friday, March 7th, 2014, will automatically be entered into a drawing to win one of 36 of this book. I'm going to give them away. I think that if you're new to art journaling, or even if you're not, this is a great primer on how to get started, and if you love Diane's techniques, this is an also great place because she's going to detail them here for you. There's lots of step-by-step photos and explanations about why she does what she does. It's a fabulous book. So again, any order placed between Wednesday, February 24th and Friday, March 7th, 2014, will automatically be entered into a drawing to win any one of 36 of these. In addition, for those of you who are new to Joggles or maybe unaware, our everyday low pricing means that you automatically receive 15% off of all of these products. It happens automatically. The website will show you the regular price and then your discounted price, and all you do is put the items in your cart and the discount is applied. So enough talking about that. Let me go ahead and get this book out of the way and let me show you these three colors. Now, I picked pomegranate seed and polished jade because I realized, and I'm going to start with actually with slate gray, but I realized when I was playing with these colors that they make a fabulous purple. Let me show you what happens. It's very earthy, and you can see the blending starting here. It's a real pretty earthy purple color that is just wonderful. I really like it a lot. I kind of obliterated my slate gray, so let me just put a little bit more in here. Now, I'm not going to roll this. I'm going to come in with my heated craft tool, and I'm just going to start drawing. And one of the things that I'm going to do is let this dry to a certain point, and then I'm going to tip the page so that I get runs and drips. I really like that look, and you can see this edge forming here where there's some pooling and puddling, and there's more here. And once I tip this, some really fun things will happen. Now, in the interim, while this is starting to dry, I am going to pick up some of what's gathered here in the crease of the page spread. Though these Strathmore art journals are sewn and glued as they're bound, there is some leakage that can happen if you really flood that seam, so I'm not going to do that because I don't want this to bleed through. But you see how pretty this purple is. What a really nice color. And I think I'm going to come back with a little bit more of the polished jade, and I'm just going to push a little bit along here and let these colors run. Turn this toward you so you can see. All right, and that's enough there. Now, let me move this out of the way. Well, you know what? With enough color on here, I think I'm going to leave it. So what I'm going to do now is start tilting so that I get colors moving and running. Again, this fabulous earthy purple forms where the pomegranate seed and the polished jade meet. I just want to kind of set these colors and these stainy looking things, and then I'm actually going to pick up here and cause the drips to run in a little bit different direction. I can probably get rid of this now to get it out of my way. I can mop up a little bit of this right here while this dries, and then I'm going to grab my paper towel and just sop up what's in there. Now, let me turn this toward you, and again, I get this fun run and drip thing that goes on here. So now that I have color on here, I'm just going to come in with some paper towel, and I'm just going to take the excess off so that we can move along. And if you watch the addition by subtraction video, you know that when you put color on and then you take it off before it's finished drying, you get this nice lightening that happens. So you get this pattern that gets added when you remove color. That's the addition by subtraction thing. So in comes, this is the large blocks, and what I'm going to do is grab my water, and I'm just going to spritz here a little bit in the middle, and then I'm going to come over here, and I think I'm going to print along this side just to let the water do its thing and to pick up some of that. Now that's kind of a little bit not as much as I would like, so let's do a little bit more up there. You'll have to give this a moment to let the water do its thing. Grab some paper towel so that once it does, I can come in and I can blot this off. Now, what I don't want to do, because I'm going to use some stamps on here afterward, what I don't want to do is make this background so busy that you lose sight of what's going on. So let me come in and I can start to lift there. I can lift along this edge, and then I can lift up here. So this looks really good. Now, obviously, when this the My Creative Journal Journey book was written, white linen was not a color in the line, so that's going to be a little bit different here. I'm just going to give this a little bit of a dry. Now, because dilutions are not permanent, and we obviously talked about this earlier, any white linen that I put on here is going to, let me find my stencil, is going to change color a little bit as it picks up the underlying color. So I think I'm going to put, this is the large bubble stamp. Oops. I want to come in and I want to get some on this corner. Love, love, love this stencil. I think it's wonderful. It's one I know I'm going to reach for a lot. Oops, my bottle is getting kind of empty there. All right, so now I have white linen on here. Again, fabulous for creating pattern and texture, and it's fun because it'll pick up some of the color underneath. It'll lighten a little bit as it dries, and it's obviously going to change color a little bit, and you can see that kind of going on over here. With that layer dry, the next thing I'm going to do, again, a la the book, is I'm going to bring in a stamp, and I'm going to bring in an ink pattern. In this case, I'm going to use a color that blends in with the background here a little bit. This is from the basic background set, and I kind of like this because I've got circles here which mimic the design of the bubbles. I think it provides some nice continuity. So all I'm going to do is just come in and pick up part of this design. I'm really not interested in stamping perfectly. I just want to add some pattern and texture to this page. Pick up different parts of the stamp to get different areas. I can do light, I can do dark. It really doesn't make a darn bit of difference. All I want to do is just add some texture, and I think that's enough. Now again, sort of following along with the theme in the book, the next step would be to bring in some paint and to put some painted elements on here. Now obviously I'm not showing you everything in the book. I mean, you want to have the book for your own use, and this is just a sampling of the kinds of ways that Di does her backgrounds and her journal pages. So this is just Tim's Distress Paint. I'm going to push a little bit of white out and a little bit of black. Again, you have to shake these paints. Oops, a little bit of crusty stuff that fell off there. Let me get a little bit of black going. I don't need much for this. These are just some different size caps. I like them because you can nest one inside the other. Again, I don't ever want to think I'm striving for perfection, so I'm just going to lightly tap this in here, let it run off the page in some cases. Then I can use the other size to create some different size ones. Again, I like the idea of the continuity that's presented by using this circle element. If you have some other shapes, you can certainly use them as well. So now I can come in with some black in various places, and then I can come in with the small version in some places. You can stamp them and nest them. You can stamp them alone. It really, well, that does not want to stamp. It doesn't make any difference at all. That's better. Now I've got some on there. Now, once this dries, my next step is going to be to use another stamp, and I'm actually going to, get this out of the way, I'm going to put some stuff, and you'll see in a moment what that stuff is. I'm going to put some stuff here along the top, and then I would probably at this point call this done. I don't want it to get overly busy, but it's got enough going on so that I can come in and I can collage some elements on here, or I can write on here, or any combination. Whatever you do, whatever you're compelled to do when you work on a journal page will work. These are just some additional techniques that you can use to get your backgrounds going and to create some nice interesting patterns and layers and texture. With everything completely dry, now I'm going to bring in this stamp from the Further Around the Edge set. Now I like this. I like to do leaves that kind of droop down into the picture from, or into your page spread from the top. And since this is oriented with the top facing me, I'm actually going to turn it this way. I find it easier to do this way. Don't ask me why. It just is. Now when I arrange these, I can kind of do anything I want. I think I'm going to arrange them so that they start longer, then they get shorter, and then they start longer. It almost presents a stage curtain kind of look, and I like that. So I'm going to start in the middle. And I'm going to do these reasonably short to begin with. And if you get a less than perfect impression, all you have to do, and in fact I did right there, all you have to do is come in with a Pitt pen, and you can just, well, that's a crappy Pitt pen that does not want to write. You can just come in and you can extend whatever your elements are, there we go, so that your image is a little bit more complete. So that's how you do that. So let me just come in and finish this up. Now again, because I want to create that kind of stage effect, what I'm going to do is make these elements a little bit longer each time. And one of the nice things about starting in the center is that you don't have to fight placement so that your stamp would span both pages in the spread. If you start in the center, then you can work from the center outward, and if you run off the edge of a page, then that's not a big deal, and it's far easier to do than trying to stamp in that center and span those two pages. It's just next to impossible to do well. All right, so this side is done, and I'll do the same thing over here to finish this. So again, coming back to the book, if I could find it, I've set it down someplace here. This is a great book. Whether you're a novice journaler, someone who's just looking to get started, or you already consider yourself, you know, an advanced journaler, there's lots of fun things in here that you can do. There's ideas, you know, just plenty of techniques and lots of inspiration. I hope you get to use this journal, this book, My Creative Journal Journey. Hope you get to work in your journals, and mostly I hope that you get to use these 6 new colors and the new stencils that were released, because they are just some wonderful designs and, as I said, fabulous colors.